Good morning, dear students. We are going to discuss lymphatic drainage of head and neck. So the lymphatic drainage of head and neck, it has regional groups. The regional group of lymph nodes we have studied many times when we were doing different regions. So we have occipital group of lymph nodes, retroauricular, also called as mastoid. Retro is behind the ear, that is towards mastoid process. Preauricular is in front of the ear where we have parotid gland. Then we have buccal, that is facial. So like below the mandible, we have submandibular group of lymph nodes. Below the chin, we have submental group of lymph nodes. And in front of the neck, we have anterior cervical, superficial cervical. Retropharyngeal is behind the pharynx. Laryngeal and tracheal, which are pre and paratracheal. Pre is in front of trachea, para is on either side of the tracheal rings. So all these are region wise we have named them. Then we have terminal group, which is nothing but deep cervical group of lymph nodes. So once we have named these lymph nodes, now let us see like where exactly these lymph nodes are present. Like see, this is the external acoustic meatus. In front of the ear, we call it as preauricular, also called as parotid. Around the buccinator muscle, like very close to the buccinator muscle, like near the cheek, we have buccal group of lymph nodes. Below the chin, we have submental group of lymph nodes. Okay, so below the mandible bone, we have submandibular group of lymph nodes. In front of the neck, we have anterior cervical group of lymph nodes. At the occipital bone, that is occipital group of lymph nodes. Behind the ear, we call it as posterior auricular, also called as mastoid group of lymph nodes. So all these lymph nodes are coming under the category of superficial nodes in the head and neck region. Okay, so we have lymph nodes around the external jugular vein, which are also superficial group of lymph nodes. Okay. So like a close-up picture of these lymph nodes, below the mandible, we have submandibular group of lymph nodes, okay? Then, so we also have like all these superficial group of lymph nodes will be going into the deep group of lymph nodes, which are nothing but the deep cervical group of lymph nodes, okay? So in the midline, we have retropharyngeal, infrahyoid, pre-laryngeal, pre-tracheal and paratracheal. Now you can see these lymph nodes in the neck region. Okay, so the ones which are shown in green color, they are superior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Like the ones which are shown in blue color, these are inferior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Below the chin, we have submental group of lymph nodes. Below the mandible bone, we have submandibular group of lymph nodes. In front of the larynx, we have pre-laryngeal group of lymph nodes. In front of trachea, we have pre-tracheal group of lymph nodes. Okay, so you can see this one more picture. This picture has been taken from behind. Okay, this is the skull bone. Okay, and you are finding these are the pharyngeal muscles, superior, middle and inferior constrictor group of muscles. Okay, so here we have the pharyngeal group of lymph nodes. Okay, then all of this lymph, we know like the lymph, what is the main channel through, like into which whole of the lymph flows? We know that is the lymphatic duct. In the oral cavity, we will have a ring which is called as Waldeyer's lymphatic ring. The Waldeyer's lymphatic ring is chiefly comprised of the palatine tonsils. Okay, then we have like the lingual group of lymph nodes, like you call it as lingual tonsil. We have pharyngeal tonsil and tubal tonsil. All together, it forms a ring which is called as Waldeyer's lymphatic ring. Okay. Waldeyer's tonsillar ring consisting of unpaired pharyngeal tonsil in the roof of the pharynx, paired palatine tonsils and lingual tonsils scattered at the root of the tongue, and also at the opening of the like eustachian tube, we have tubal tonsil. All together it forms Waldeyer's lymphatic ring. So the vertical chain, like lymphatic drainage of head and neck, which has vertical chain, which has consists of superior and inferior group of lymph nodes related to carotid sheath, All lymph vessels of head and neck drain into deep cervical group of lymph nodes, either directly from the tissues or indirectly via other lymph nodes in outlying in that particular area. So lymph is returned to systemic circulation via either right lymphatic duct or the thoracic duct. So these are the various group of lymph nodes. In the face, we have facial group of lymph nodes, and in the parotid region, we have so many other below the mandible, submandibular, submental, retropharyngeal, anterior cervical group of lymph nodes. Okay. Now coming to the superficial group of lymph nodes, in the occipital region, we have 2 to 4 occipital lymph nodes which are located like at the superior nuchal line between sternocleidomastoid and trapezius. The occipital group of lymph nodes are receiving lymph, that is afferents, from occipital part of the scalp. The lymph from the occipital group of lymph nodes will move out through efferent lymphatic vessels like through superficial cervical lymph nodes and accessory lymph nodes. That means lymph from this occipital area will move to superficial cervical lymph nodes and accessory lymph nodes. Mastoid group of lymph nodes, which are towards mastoid process, they are situated superficial to sternocleidomastoid insertion. The mastoid group of lymph nodes receives lymph from posterior parietal scalp, skin of the ear, posterior external meatus. These lymph nodes are draining, that means the efferents are taking the lymph to superficial deep cervical lymph nodes and accessory lymph nodes. Preauricular lymph nodes are situated in front of the ear, anterior to ear, over parotid fascia. The preauricular or parotid lymph nodes receives lymph from superficial, like the areas which are supplied by superficial temporal artery, anterior parietal scalp area, anterior surface of ear. The lymph from preauricular lymph nodes will drain into superior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Now see, this is the parotid group of lymph nodes which are situated in front of the ear, embedded in the parotid gland. Just below the parotid gland, they drain the root of the nose, eyelids, frontotemporal region, external auditory meatus, nasal cavity, parotid gland. The lymph that is drains. It is draining into, that means the lymph, these are afferents and these are efferents. Efferents are going to superficial deep cervical lymph nodes. Now coming to parotid. So about parotid glands and under parotid fascia, deep to parotid gland. So it is collecting the lymph. The parotid group of lymph nodes. About parotid and under parotid fascia, deep to parotid gland. So it is collecting lymph from the external acoustic meatus, skin of frontal and temporal regions, eyelids, tympanic cavity, cheek, nose, and they will be draining into superior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Now coming to in the face region, in the superficial area, we have maxillary, buccal and mandibular group of lymph nodes, which are distributed along the course of facial artery and facial vein. The afferents are collecting lymph from skin and mucous membrane of eyelids, nose and cheek. Efferents are taking lymph to submandibular nodes. Now, the deep group of lymph nodes in the face region is distributed along the course of maxillary artery, lateral to lateral pterygoid muscle. So it is collecting lymph from the temporal and infratemporal fossa and nasal pharynx. And the lymph from here, efferents are taking the lymph to superior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Now the cervical group of lymph nodes are superficial and deep. The superficial ones are collecting afferents. Okay, that is anterior jugular vein between, it is situated between anterior jugular vein between superficial cervical fascia and infrahyoid fascia. Afferents, it collects superficial cervical group of lymph nodes, collects lymph from skin, muscles and viscera of infrahyoid region of neck. And the lymph from here, through efferent, it is reaching to superior deep cervical lymph nodes. The deep cervical lymph nodes are situated between viscera of neck and investing layer of deep cervical fascia. The afferents are collecting lymph from the adjoining parts of trachea, larynx and thyroid gland. Efferents are going to superior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. We have anterior cervical, also called as superficial group of lymph nodes, that is submental group of lymph nodes, which are seen in the submental triangle, which you have seen in anterior triangle of neck. Afferents, it receives lymph from chin, medial part of lower lip, lower incisor, teeth and gingiva, gums, tip of the tongue and cheeks. The lymph from submental group of lymph nodes is moving to submandibular lymph node, to jugulo-omohyoid lymph node and superior deep cervical lymph nodes. So these are efferents. Now these are the submental, that is below chin, midline of the jaw, below chin, between the anterior belly soft, digastric of both sides. Now you can see this is afferents collecting the lymph, that is drains central portion of lip, tip of the tongue, anterior portion of the floor of the mouth. From here the lymph is moving into submandibular group and deep cervical group of lymph nodes. It's written here, drains and draining into. Let's be clear, drains is afferent, draining into is efferent, E. Now submandibular group of lymph nodes, which are situated in the submandibular triangle, nothing but digastric triangle, adjacent to submandibular gland. So afferents, it collects lymph from facial group of lymph nodes, chin, lateral upper and lower lips, submental lymph nodes, cheeks and nose, anterior nasal cavity, maxillary and mandibular teeth, gingiva, oral palate, lateral parts of anterior two-thirds of the tongue. The submandibular group of lymph nodes, they drain the lymph into superior deep cervical, like draining into, that means efferents are going to superior deep cervical lymph nodes and jugulo-omohyoid lymph nodes. Superficial cervical group of lymph nodes are one or two in number. They are situated along external jugular vein, superficial to external carotid muscle. Superficial cervical lymph nodes receive afferents from the lower part of the ear and parotid region. Efferents, that means it is draining into superior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Okay, so this is submandibular. These are afferents, drains, where the side of the nose, upper lip, a lateral portion of the lower lip, mid portion of the eyelids, buccal mucosa, cheek, anterolateral margins of the tongue, gingiva, nothing but gums, and drains into deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Draining into is nothing but efferent. Drains is nothing but afferent. Okay. So superficial cervical group of lymph nodes, this is situated along external jugular vein, anterior to sternocleidomastoid muscle. It is collecting lymph from external ear, parotid gland, and it drains into deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Now, deep cervical group of lymph nodes, we have superior deep cervical, which is situated surrounding internal jugular vein deep to sternocleidomastoid and superior to omohyoid muscle. Afferents from occipital, mastoid, preauricular, parotid, submandibular, superficial cervical lymph nodes and retropharyngeal. The lymph from superior deep cervical will move through efferents into inferior deep cervical lymph nodes or separate channel to jugulo-subclavian junction. Jugulodigastric, they are situated at the junction of internal jugular vein and posterior digastric muscle. The deep cervical lymph nodes receive lymph from palatine and lingual tonsil, posterior palate, lateral portion of the anterior two-thirds of the tongue. The efferents are draining the lymph into inferior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. So these are the deep superior cervical lymphatics, which are situated in the course of the carotid artery and internal jugular vein behind the sternocleidomastoid. Afferents are from the back of the neck, occipital region of the scalp, portion of the external ear, okay, posterior and central portion of the tongue, palate, nasopharynx, nose, larynx and upper esophagus. These are all afferents. Efferents are going to jugular trunk. Now, jugulo-omohyoid, they are situated above junction of internal jugular vein and omohyoid muscle. Jugulo-omohyoids collect lymph from the posterior one-third of the tongue, submandibular lymph nodes and submental nodes. These are afferents. Efferents are going to inferior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Inferior deep cervical, they are situated along internal jugular vein below omohyoid muscle deep to sternocleidomastoid. They are like afferents are nothing but collecting lymph from transverse cervical nodes, anterior cervical nodes, superior deep cervical nodes. From here, the lymph is moving to jugular trunk through efferents. Retropharyngeal lymph nodes, which are behind the pharynx, which are 1 to 3 in number. So in the retropharyngeal space, they collect lymph from, that is afferents from posterior nasal cavity, paranasal air sinuses, hard and soft palate, nasopharynx, oropharynx, and auditory tube. Lymph from here through efferents, it is moving to superior deep cervical group of lymph nodes. Now see the deep inferior cervical lymphatics, which are situated in the inferior portion of the course of the carotid artery and internal jugular vessels. The afferents are back of the neck, lower portion of the occipital scalp, superior anterior chest wall. The efferents are going to deep jugular trunk. Accessory group of lymph nodes, which are 2 to 6 in number, they are situated along the 11th cranial nerve, that is accessory nerve in the posterior triangle. This group of lymph nodes collect lymph from occipital nodes, mastoid nodes, lateral neck and shoulder. From here, the lymph moves into transverse cervical lymph nodes. Transverse cervical lymph nodes are 1 to 10 in number, which are situated along transverse cervical artery at the level of the clavicle. So transverse cervical group of lymph nodes collect lymph from, that is afferents from accessory nodes, apical axillary nodes, lateral neck, anterior thoracic wall. The lymph from here through efferents, it is moving to jugular trunk or directly into thoracic duct or right lymphatic duct or independently into the junction of internal jugular vein and subclavian vein. So these are the various lymphatics as you can see here. Under applied anatomy, when a lymph node is under challenge because of some infection, that is foreign antigen, it may become enlarged and it may be painful to touch, which we already know it is lymph adenitis. Commonly palpated and accessible lymph nodes are cervical lymph nodes, which are palpated in the neck region, axillary lymph nodes in the axilla, inguinal lymph nodes in the inguinal region. So lymph nodes are common sites of metastatic cancers, that is the spread of cancer, because cancer cells from almost any organ can break loose, enter the lymphatic capillaries, and they can easily lodge in the lymph nodes. Lymph adenopathy is the enlargement of lymph nodes, isn't it? Here there are few pictures which help us to understand how to palpate this group of lymph nodes. Submandibular lymphatics may be palpated against the inferior border of the mandible. So bilateral palpation proceeds anteriorly to the submental group of lymphatics. The patient should be in relaxed upright position to palpate along sternocleidomastoid. The superficial cervical lymphatics may be found anterior to this muscle. The deep superior cervical lymph nodes may be palpated against the upper part of the sternocleidomastoid. The deep inferior cervical lymphatics may be palpated against the lower sternocleidomastoid. So that's how we generally do the palpation. So superficial cervical, supraclavicular, and lymph nodes of anterior triangle can be easily palpated, as you have seen just now. Spinal root of accessory nerve may get entangled in the enlarged lymph nodes situated in the posterior triangle of neck. While taking biopsy of lymph node, one must be very careful not to injure accessory nerve. Otherwise, trapezius, which is supplied by the accessory nerve, gets damaged. The left supraclavicular lymph nodes are also called as Virchow's lymph nodes. Cancer from stomach and testis may spread, metastasize into these lymph nodes, which may become palpable. In supraclavicular lymph nodes, we can palpate to check if there is any stomach cancer or testicular carcinoma. Thank you.